If you're trying to decide between the M4 MacBook Air or the M4 MacBook Pro, there's a few things you need to be aware of before making your choice because, depending on your use case, the computer that you're going to want is going to be drastically different. And in this video, we're going to talk about the differences between these computers so you can make the best possible choice. We're going to have links for all my favorite MacBooks in the description below, or if you need personalized help with picking one out, I've also got a contact form there so you can send me a message and we can work together to pick the best Mac for you. So the first thing to know about the MacBook Air and the MacBook Pro is the focus of the computers. So the MacBook Air is really focused on portability and being as lightweight as possible, a great computer for your average day-to-day user. It's going to be targeted more towards office professionals, students, or users who do light creative work. The MacBook Pro, on the other hand, is designed to be more of a media powerhouse for users who need the best possible screen quality and who have more demanding workloads and who need dedicated fans. What's really cool about the MacBook Air, though, is it has a fanless design, so you're never going to have to worry about fan noise, and it runs pretty cool most of the time. Another thing about the MacBook Air is it has plenty of power available in it as well, and I've tested out some of the more demanding workload that I'll do with video editing on the MacBook Air. It handles it just fine, although it does get hotter, and you will notice some thermal throttling that will slow the performance of the computer as well. But for your day-to-day tasks, there's no issues with running just a MacBook Air. Now, if we're talking physical differences in the computers, the MacBook Air now comes with the MagSafe charger, as well as two Thunderbolt 4 ports, which is fantastic for plugging in a variety of high-quality peripherals. You can also run two external displays on the MacBook Air now. Previously, you were limited to just one, so the M4 has really done a lot for the MacBook Air. You also still get the headphone jack on the side of the Air as well. The MacBook Pro has three Thunderbolt ports, the MagSafe port, an HDMI port, and also an SD card slot, and you still get the headphone jack as well. So what's really great about the Pro is that extra Thunderbolt port gives you even more expansion capabilities, and the HDMI really comes in handy for using the computer for presentations or if you just need to go hardwire straight into a monitor without any additional peripherals. Also, as a photographer and videographer, the built-in SD card slot always comes in handy as well. Apple has also changed the game with the M4 MacBook Pros, and now you can get it with either the base M4 chip, the M4 Pro chip, or the M4 Max chip. It's about $400 if you get that same base chip, but they will have all the same exact features in terms of what the chips are able to do. So you get all the same video encode and decode engines, the same neural engines, the same graphic cores. It's all going to be identical. So really the thing that you have to ask yourself is if you want to spend the extra money to get the Pro, because if you get a 13-inch MacBook Air or the 14-inch MacBook Pro, then the 14-inch MacBook Pro is going to be just a little bit bigger. It's going to weigh about 0.7 pounds more, and it's going to give you the fans on the inside of it, additional ports, and the screen on it is probably the biggest difference. So the MacBook Air screen is very high quality, has that Retina resolution, but on the Pro, the screen is able to be at double the brightness in peak situations, and it also supports higher quality HDR content, which again, most people are not going to notice the difference or even care because both of the displays are very color accurate and very bright. So I love both of the displays on the MacBook Air and the MacBook Pro, but the Pro one is definitely a step above the Air. The thing that gets tricky though is as soon as you start to upgrade your MacBook Air to a MacBook Pro, then you have to start thinking, should you get the M4 Pro chip or should you get the M4 Max chip instead? I really recommend if you're doing any sort of professional photo editing, go up from the M4 to the M4 Pro chip because you'll appreciate the additional graphics cores and CPU cores that are going to make your workload a little bit easier. And then if you're doing video editing, then that's when you should really look into getting the M4 Max chip. Get the M4 Max chip for video editing, 3D rendering, or also as we move into more and more AI LLM models being run on computers, then that's when we're going to really appreciate the performance that the M4 Max is able to offer on the MacBook Pro. One other difference between the two displays is the MacBook Air tops out at 60 Hertz and the MacBook Pro is going to give you that ProMotion variable refresh rate, which is going to give you super smooth scrolling and also going to allow for other very high frame rate playback on your computer. So if you're trying to decide which computer to get, if you need a lightweight laptop for everyday use with a little bit of creative work sprinkled in, that's when the MacBook Air is going to be the better option for you. And then you can choose between either the 13 or 15-inch screen on it, depending on how much screen real estate you need. And then if you're someone who demands the higher screen quality, the extra ports, the extra power that the MacBook Pro has to offer, that's when you need to look into the three MacBook Pro models, either the M4, the M4 Pro, or the M4 Max. If you're just a day-to-day user who wants the extra ports and the better screen, get the M4 MacBook Pro. If you're doing audio or light photo editing and a little bit of light video editing sprinkled in, that's when I would get the M4 Pro MacBook Pro. Or if you're a video editor, 3D rendering, looking for more AI models, that's when I would recommend the M4 Max MacBook Pro. You can get the MacBook Pro either in the 14-inch or 16-inch size. If you're interested in buying a Mac, I'm gonna have links for all my favorite computers in the description below. Or if you need personalized help picking out a computer, I've also got a contact form where you can fill out a couple details and I'll get back to you and help you pick out the best computer for your use case. If you got any other questions, leave a comment down below. Love to answer them. Like this video, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any upcoming content.